All right, we've got a ASUS here, and this one has an issue with the most likely the middle pin not touching. Seems to be currently on. No? Okay, it's a bit hot. Okay, it's currently on. Oh, nice. Beautiful laptop. Let's open this up and have a look at its charging port. That's where the issue is. So when you wiggle around the charging cable, the charging light comes on and goes. So we assume a loose connection. Let's have a look. Okay, the ones on the ends, they don't come out. Okay, so there is two LED cables, one on the left, one on the right. Looks like Wi-Fi cable is part of the motherboard. Battery is there, that's the charging port. Good. So what I'd like to check is, how can I check this? All right, let's figure out a way to check this. Have a look in voltage mode. Get a ground. Too close, somewhere else. Okay. See if that's a good ground we can use. Okay. Voltage mode. Okay. All right, so we can't see the multimeter, here we go. Okay. See that? Zero. Okay, so he did go to another computer shop, in fact, two of them. They said charging port is fine, sorry, charger adapter is fine. But to me, there's a lot of rust in here. Why is there rust? Okay, best way to check. I think I've got a same one, same plug. Now they did say, client did say, they tried a, what do you call it, a complete new charger and still the same issue. So he's been hunting around in Sydney looking for someone to change the port. Could be the port, could be the charger. So this is our charger, and it's clean inside. That clicks in. How about their one? Also clicks in, okay. So we're going to bring our own charger, which is now plugged in, and voltage mode, ground, okay, let's play around. Okay, yeah, definitely the charging port. Let's see what we can do about this, yeah? We need to disassemble the board. Okay. Battery needs to be coming out, okay. Take a photo of these guys. Alright, so we've got the original port here. We're going to remove it out of this and put it onto the other one. Okay. So what we'll do, come in with low melt solder. Okay. Wonderful. So now this will just fall off. Apply a little bit of pressure from the bottom. I don't know, I'm gonna apply pressure. I think I'll do it like this on an angle. Yeah. Beautiful, all original condition. We'll repeat the same process here. Thank you. Okay, good. Cleaning up. Nope, too much. Now the other side of the board, just check here, why don't we clean these guys too, see if we can, especially these guys. Okay, so same with this one, we're gonna again do the same thing and How do we get this guy out? Very difficult to clean. Those tiny little ports. Try again. Okay. Now it's a question of, is this the way it goes in? One sec. Yeah, that's correct. That's the way it goes in. So we can apply heat and just press down and it should be fine. What we'll do, we'll make a little raised area on the bottom of it. And then we will push it down. It should go in there nicely. Okay, that's all looking good. I'll just check if this port goes in nicely. Yeah, it does. Okay, that's it. Okay, so it's a new day. Client hasn't come back to us what they want to do about the cooling yet, but we'll do a test. We'll put it in the board. We'll put it back in this, in the shit. It's become a fishing line. Okay. Alright, so we finished the DC jack replacement. We'll just put a photo on that. Oh, goodness me. Okay. This gooey stuff is everywhere. It's like a paste. Okay. Okay. So now what we'll do is plug in the fans. Just make sure. Oh, no, we don't need the fans. What we'll do is I want to see if this guy, is there any power indicator? Maybe I'll plug in a USB LED light. Okay. All right, we'll plug this in. Okay, let's see if there is a 19 volts. Yeah, we have 19 volts. So I'm just gonna now, as before, fiddle around. It does seem to be a little bit funny. What I will do is just to be sure, I mean it's working. I will Okay. Just check those connections one more time, especially the one at the very middle. That's a very important one. And that is on this side. It's that guy there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to apply, I know it's already good there, but still, just apply a little bit more solder to that guy. Oh my god. Okay. That's so interesting. That pin is so close to the other one, the 19 volts there. That's better. Okay. Yeah. Okay, and I'd like to also check in continuity which pins are which, out of curiosity. I wonder where that guy is going. There's definitely another pin there. I'm going to solder that one too. A little bit more. Okay, just make sure they're not touching each other. Last thing we want is 19 volt going into 3 volts or something. Okay. Good. Okay. So, next question is, what are we going to do with the thermal paste and whatnot? So this one uses a special one, and our one, the one we've got, thermal. This stuff. So we can't have this guy be conductive, which is what I'm going to check now. Is this guy conductive or not? No, it's not. Good. Okay, we might use this stuff or we might not, we'll see. Anything else to it? I think nothing else. We'll be most likely cleaning these fans, and ASUS made it so these don't open. They're rivet style, no screws. Give them a nice blow, new thermal paste and whatnot, and she'll be good to go. Okay, that's the end of this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.